Keats.
So I came as the title of the movie, The Bright Star. When else could I wear this shirt? Anyway, beauty is a joy forever is the great line from the movie. And I'm sitting here with the gentleman who plays John Keats, Ben Whishaw. Very nice to meet you.
Pleased to meet you.
Oh my God, what a great performance. What a great role to have. My God, yeah. John Keats, wow.
Yeah, such a privilege to play a human being like that. I think he was an amazing soul, you know.
And I never knew his story. You want to tell our viewers?
Yeah, well, it's a kind of beautiful story and a sad one. But he was a kind of struggling poet, a poet not really recognized at all in his time. Quite the opposite, in fact.
Which is so strange, because he's considered one of the greatest.
Now he's considered one of the greatest, but then not at all. And he's kind of a man surrounded by death. His family, his mother and father were dead. His brothers were dying or moving away. And
all of consumption?
All from tuberculosis.
Wow.
And then when he was 23, he moved in with his best friend, Charles Brown, and met the girl who lived next door, Fanny Braun, and they fell in love with each other.
And he wrote like all these incredible poems sort of to her, more or less, inspired by her.
I think that she was definitely the muse. They're often not even about, the poems often aren't even about love, but they're definitely kind of inspired by her presence, I think. And then I think maybe a year and a half into their romance, Keats became ill as well. And then it's a very sort of swift decline, really, and he was dead by the age of 25.
25?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
And you were in His Dark Materials.
I was on stage, yeah.
Yes, with my friend Dominic Cooper.
Yes, yeah.
At the National. What were you playing in that? That was a science fiction thing,
yeah,
wasn't it?
It was, and I was playing a kind of church cleric and then other
and
sundry
Sam
parts.
And Sam Barnett was
Sam,
in it.
Sam Barnett was in it as the Pantalaimon, the demon.
Oh, he was?
Yeah.
And Dominic was like...
And Dominic was...
The lead?
Yeah, I forget the
or
name
so
of the
so he said.
Character. You know, he was. He was the lead.
He was the background.
Yeah, we were all in it. Yeah, yeah.
Back at the National.
I was very much in the background.
Yeah, and so I know I've interviewed you so many times for the History Boys, and you weren't... So you're part of that class of National
I missed
National
the
Theater.
History Boys, yeah, but I was there at the same time, yeah.
Right, yeah. But I mean, such talented young actors come out of England, like, constantly. What do you think... What do you attribute that to, you think?
I think there's a really amazing tradition of actors. I mean, and perhaps it's something to do with the theatre. I mean, I think that
which
most
is so
actors,
alive in London.
Yeah,
yes.
It's so alive, and so many actors in London or in England go through that still as a kind of learning process, and often remain in the theatre their whole lives. Like Dominic's doing a play at the moment, I know, and. I'm
Phaedra,
doing about
right?
to do one.
With
yeah.
Ellen,
yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Do they both get naked in it, or am I just guessing? Knowing Helen and knowing him.
I've not seen it. I couldn't possibly comment.
Coming to New York, though. And you're also just finishing, you just did a movie with Julie?
Yeah.
Tamer?
The Tempest, yes.
And who were you playing in that?
I was playing Ariel opposite Helen Mirren's Prospera. Yeah.
Oh, well, we're going to have to watch for that. And I'm getting the wind-up sign, so we have to wind this up with Ben Whishaw and the new Jane Campion film, Bright Star.
Lovely
to meet you. Thank you so much.
You.
Yes, lovely to meet you too, sir.